Hi guys, welcome back to my new video, and today in this video we will learn to make a website in WordPress. This is the website that we are going to create in this video. This is the home page. Let's click on this menu. So this is the about page, then services page, then the last one is contact page. All the pages looks very beautiful and it is loading very quickly. It is because of my web hosting and caching. That also you will see in this video. To build a WordPress website, we need a domain name and web hosting. For that, we will come to the website Bluehost. And I would like to thanks Bluehost for sponsoring this video. Now you may ask why I am recommending you Bluehost. So come to the official website of WordPress, click on this hosting, and here you can see Bluehost is the number one hosting recommended by WordPress. Let's come back to the Bluehost website. From this drop-down menu, open the shared hosting. Scroll down. Here you will see different hosting plan. In the basic plan, you can create a single website, and in the plus plan, you can create unlimited website. With any Blue hosting plan, you will get free SSL certificate that you can enable in just one click. You will get a free domain name for 1 year. And one more thing, you will get free Bluehost SEO tools, which is very good to track your website SEO score, keywords and competitors. That also I will show you in this video. So I just want to create single website, so I will choose basic plan. Let me click on this button, select. Now it is asking for a domain name. If you already have a domain name, enter here, or here you can search for a new domain that you will get for free. So let me search for avinashkr.com domain name. I am getting this warning because I have already purchased this domain and web hosting with this domain. So let's search for another domain name. Let me write avinashkr2.com. Now you can see this message, this domain name is available. Next, you have to create an account here. Simply fill the below account information, scroll down, and here you have to select the package information. You can see if you will buy this hosting for longer duration, you will get maximum discount. I will select for 12 months. You can uncheck these things in the package extra. It is not compulsory. Next, you have to enter the payment information. You can pay using credit card, or you can also pay using any debit card, net banking, by selecting this PayU payment gateway. Select this checkbox, click on the submit button and complete your purchase. After getting your domain name and web hosting, you will come to this login page. You can log in using your email ID or your domain name. Let me log in with my domain name and password. When you will log in for first time, you will get this page. Here simply click on this skip. Again, I will click on this skip. And here also, I will click on skip. Let's skip this step also. And on this page also, I will skip. Here it is asking, pick a free or premium theme. So we will install the theme later. I can skip this step also. So let's scroll down and click here, skip this step. Now it is installing WordPress on our domain name. All right, after WordPress installation, you will come to this page. Here, just click on this My Sites. Now click on this button, Manage Site. Then let's come to this tab Settings. Here you can see a domain name, which is a temporary domain name. So remove this one and write the domain name that you have purchased. So I will write my domain name. In this home URL also write the same thing, then save these changes. That's it. You will get this success message. After that, you can log into your WordPress. So simply click on this button, login into WordPress. Let me open this in the new tab. And we are in the WordPress dashboard. Let's open our website in a new tab. I will click here and I will open this website in new tab. You can see this is the basic WordPress website. So there is nothing much on this web page. We have to add different theme and we have to add content. So let's come back to the dashboard and let's click on this settings, then permalinks. Here select this option post name, so it will make your URL SEO friendly. Save these changes. Now let's come to the plugins. Here you can see we have lots of plugins activated on this web page that we don't need right now. So I will deactivate some of these plugins like this one. Let me check these plugins. I will deactivate all plugins together. Click on this drop down, select deactivate and apply. That's it. Now you can see this left sidebar looks simple. Make sure you do not deactivate this Bluehost plugin. It should be active. Now let's come to the users. And here you can see the username. Then click on this edit. It is the username, you can't change it. And here you can write your name. I will write my name here. Let me write the nickname also. Display name, I will select this. And here I will update the password. So let's click here, set new password. Enter the new password here. Make sure you write a strong password. Then click on update profile. Now you have the username and password also. So you can log into your WordPress dashboard. So let me log out for now. After logout, you will come to this login page. You can also get this login page by typing your domain name / wp-admin like this / wp-admin, hit enter, and you will come to this login page. Write your username and password. You can also use the email ID also to log into your WordPress dashboard. So now we are back to our WordPress dashboard. Let's click here on this Bluehost. Let me come to the home page. Here you can see this message, coming soon active. Here also in the dashboard you can see coming soon active. So click on the settings. And in this site controls, you can see coming soon. So just you have to turn it off. Click here. Now it is off. And scroll down here, you can see performance. In this performance, you can see caching. So Bluehost has already enabled the recommended caching settings. You can see a toggle button here. You can use this toggle option to turn on and turn off your caching for your website. And at the bottom, you can see this button, clear everything. So you can use this button to clear cache on your website. Let me come to the homepage and refresh the website. You can see there is no warning now. Right now you can see in the browser it is saying not secure because we have not activated the SSL and our website is right now on the HTTP. So we have to move this website on the HTTPS. So to do that, we will come back to the Bluehost cPanel. Here in this site URL, you have to add HTTPS. And in the home URL also write the HTTPS. It should be same. Then save these changes. After that, come to the security tab. Here you can see SSL certificate. we have a toggle button here, so we have to turn it on. So after turning on this SSL, let's close this tab and open the website again. I will write my domain name here. And now you can see a secure lock icon in front of this domain name. And you can see right now it is on the HTTPS. So we have successfully activated the SSL certificate on our domain name. Next, we have to customize our website. So let's come back to the dashboard. In this dashboard also, you can see this secure icon. Let's click on this appearance. Here you can see some themes which is already installed. So let's click on this button, WordPress.org themes. Scroll down and here you can see lots of themes that you can use to create different websites. I will search for a specific theme, Astra. Search this one. So here's the theme. I will click on the install button. After installation, click on the activate. That's it. Now you can see this message here. Thank you for installing Astra. Get started. Click on this button. Now it is asking to select the page builder. So I will go with the Elementor. Here we have different demo content that we can import on our website in just one click. Just a scroll down, you can see we have different kind of demo content for different kind of website. Let me come to the top and I will search for agency. So we will get the demo content for the agency website. Let's scroll down and I will import this demo content, digital agency. So just click here and click on import complete site. In this drop down, select beginner and here select myself. Then click on next button. Here let's click on the skip. First it will install the required plugin and it will download the demo contents on our website. That's it. Now you can see this message imported successfully. Visit site. Let's click here. And now you can see the demo content has been added on our website. Let me scroll down and you can see this complete page looks beautiful. Let me click on the another page about. This page is also complete. Let's click on the services. It is also fine. And click on the contact. So this contact page is also looking very nice. Next, we have to customize this website according to our requirement. We have to add our logo and our content images. So just come back to the dashboard and here we will click on the customize. Click on the header builder. Then click on logo. And here you can upload your own logo. Select this one and upload logo. Then click on this select button. Now click here, skip cropping. You can see this logo on the web page. Here you can change the size of this logo. You can drag like this to change the size. After that, let's come back and click on this button. Here you can change the button text. I will write buy now. So if you want to add any link for this button that you can paste here, you can write another page relative link here like this. So I will write hashtag only, then click on publish. Let's come back and here we can change the menu. Let's click here, then click on configure menu from here. Then click here Edit menu. You can see this is the home. This is about. We can change it. I will write about us. This is services. Let me change it to something else. I'll write portfolio. You can see it is changing on this web page. Let's click on the publish. Let me add one more item here. I will click here and I'll write products. Then click on add button. So it will add one page and it will link it to the menu. You can see it is coming on the web page. We can drag this one to change its order. So I will drag like this. I will keep the contact at the end. Publish it. Let's come back and here you can see the option footer builder. Let's click here and scroll down this web page. In this footer you can see we have four columns. So here let's click on the first widget. Click here and replace the image. Select the already uploaded image and you can see the logo image has been replaced. We can change this text from here. Let's come back and I will click on another widget. You can change the menu here. Let's click on the fourth one. Click here, get in touch. And here we can change the title and we can change the contents here. Let me remove this one. I will write my another address here. Like this, we can easily update the contents on this website. Click on the publish and save these changes. Let's come back and we will click on the social. Here we can update the social media icons. Here we have Facebook, Twitter and other things. So let's remove this one. I will click on this button to add a new one. Select this drop down to add a different icon. Search like this. Now here we can change the title and now you can see this icon has been added. So we have added LinkedIn two times. So let me remove this. Now we have to update the URL also. So click here and here we can add the social media profile link like this. Add these links here. In the Twitter you can add, in Instagram like this, then click on publish. Let's come back and next we will change the copyright message. Click here and here we can write our own custom copyright text. Let me remove this and I will write my own message here. Then I will click on publish. You can see it got updated here on this web page. Let me close this and come to the dashboard again. And next we will click on the pages. Here we have all the pages that we have on this website. So we will edit the home page. So let me click on this home. I will click on edit with Elementor. Let me open it in the new tab. So with the help of Elementor, we can edit the content easily in this visual editor. If you want to edit any part, just click there. So suppose I want to replace this background image. I will click here on these dots, click on the style and here click on the image. Upload a new image from your PC. Then click on insert media and you can see the image has been replaced. Now this content is coming in two columns in the left and right side. So in the right side it is blank. So let me remove the right column and we will move all the content in the center. So let me click here and click on this center alignment. Let me delete the first one. I will keep this title. I will make it center. Now we'll click on the description. Here also I will update as center. For this button also, I will align in the center. Let me add a line break here. So click here, come to the content, hit enter, and it will come to the next line. So now this text looks good. Next we will update this title. So come here and I will update this. Now we will also change the title size. So just come here and click on style. Then click on typography. Click on this edit icon and we can drag like this to change its size. Now you can see we have more space between the small description and button, so we have to remove this space. For that, I'll click on this button. Then click on advance. And in this margin, I will reduce it to 0. Update these changes. You can see this banner area looks good. Let's scroll down and you can see wherever you move the cursor, you will get an edit icon, a pencil icon over there. Click there and you can replace the text, you can replace the image, and you can also update the size and color. Suppose you want to edit this one. Let me click here. And in the left side, you can see this title. You can write your own title. Click on this description and in the left side, you can write your own description. Click here and you can update the icon, this small title and description. So it is very easy to update all the contents with this visual editor. So this is how we can update the content. Let me refresh our website and you can see everything has been updated. Our logo, menu and button, this text in the center and this footer also. Let me click on this Facebook icon. You can see it will open our Facebook page because we have added the Facebook link in this icon. So this was very easy to customize your website. Here you can see on this tab it is saying welcome. So we have to change our website title. For that we will come back to the dashboard. And here let's click on the settings and general. In the site title, write a title that you want to display. In your tab, I will write creative agency. I will leave this tagline like this and click on save changes. After that, refresh the website and you can see creative agency in this tab. So we have updated all the things on this website. Let's come to the Bluehost cPanel and here I will click on the performance. In this one, you can see the same thing, the single server caching control. From here also you can control the caching on your website, and Bluehost has already configured the recommended setting about the caching for our website. And after that, let's click on this marketplace. Then click on add-ons and click on Bluehost.in SEO tools that I told you, you will get it for free. So let me click here. And here we have the start plan where you can track 10 keywords, weekly ranking, 2 competitors, step-by-step SEO plan and monthly progress report. So we will get this plan for free. So on the right side you can see add SEO tools. Select this start plan, then click on buy now. On this page you can see our total price is 0. So you don't have to pay anything for this SEO tool, just click on place free order. Now we got the free SEO tool by Bluehost. Let's come back to my sites. Click on the manage site and here you can see Bluehost SEO tools widget. Here you can see the SEO score, which is 49%. Let me click on this button, manage tool. Let's see what inside this SEO tool. Click on start now. Here I'll click on the first one. Select your country here. and it is telling about your SEO score. Let's click on get started. You can click here to get the SEO report as PDF. Here it is saying you have 5 pages but no one optimized for SEO, and in the right side you can see it is saying increase your popularity, 0 backlink, which is a part of the off-page SEO. Let's click on this audit. Here you will get the audit report of your website SEO. Let's click on the optimize, and here you can check your on-page SEO scores. Right now it is 0, so first we have to set the keyword for our page. So let me click here, add a keyword. I will write the targeted keyword for my home page. I will write creative agency search, and let's select this one. Click on select. So after updating this keyword, we got the progress report of 70% for this homepage SEO that we can improve by using the on-page SEO techniques like meta tag, description, and quality contents on your website with the proper keyword distribution on it. That is part of on-page SEO that we will talk in some other video. So this was a quick information about the Bluehost free SEO tool. So let's come to the home page, and I will click on the logout so it will remove the top toolbar so it will look clear. You can see whenever I click on another pages, all the pages are loading very fast because we are using the cache provided by the Bluehost and the hosting also, which is very good. So please go to the bluehost.com and get your domain name and hosting and build your WordPress website today. I hope this video will be helpful for you. If you have any question, you can ask me in the comment section, and please like and share this video and also subscribe my channel Easy Tutorials to watch more videos like this one. Thank you so much for watching this video.